say, look, it's garbage day, and look, there's a rocker. And Daddy can make a rocking prop. So here we go.
Would you
want to
take both of them?
Nope. Oh, we got it now. Make a rocking prop.
Alright, just the last I'll be showing on these pumpkin groundbreakers. I finished my last one's pumpkin today, and I kind of went with the, yes, Nightmare Before Christmas crap. I couldn't come up with another good idea for a pumpkin. I don't know what I was thinking, but oh well. Kind of looks retarded, but he'll work. So, there you go, got all three. Just about to glue the heads down. And I might need to either shorten up the necks a little bit. I want them kind of tall. I don't want them that small. But maybe I might take the neck down a half, maybe an inch to a half inch or an inch, something like that. But this one's about where I want him. I'm going to just put a little bit more green paint on the neck. Kind of make it blend in with the body. But this is it. The pumpkin groundbreakers. If you needed to know how to do it, there you go. Watch the video. So, alright. Hope you like them. Hey, just wanted to say, I got a Facebook page up. I know Boneyard's got his, the Boneyard Creek. And I finally got me one. It's Nightmare on Normandy. So, look me up and click on like, please. Alright, Horners, I am finally finished my pumpkin groundbreakers, and I can't go with the bobblehead, because the bobblehead is, I needed bigger springs. I bought some springs from Home Depot, and it was too small. If you're going to do bobblehead stuff, or something that's got a little weight to it, you got to go with a stronger spring. I went with some little $5 springs that I got. And they pretty flexible, so they're not gonna do what I want it to do. So I just have to pick up some bigger ones. But oh well, piss on that. I'm done with that. And now it's time to start cleaning up this mess. I got a big ass mess over here, and it's time to clean this up and get started on my paper mache again. So. Oh well, paper mache sucks, but I'm gonna get started on it. But I just wanted to say that Mr. Ninjalo, it ain't no beef, buddy. It ain't no beef. It's just a joke. So don't get bent out of shape. I know I've been having fun with my Boneyard buddy over there. I'm making a couple of cuckoo videos, but it's all in fun, dude. It's all in fun. And just wanted to say sorry if we hurt your feelings, but it's all good, man. It's all good. Hope to see y'all on the SOP on Thursday, and that's about it. If you're tired of watching Ram's videos, let me know. He's uploading a video a damn minute, and I know, Ram, I'm sorry, buddy. I know you screwed up on your stuff, so have fun uploading them, buddy. Better you than me, so that's it. Little short one. Peace out. Peace out in the man caving. In the back cave. Who that? Oh, one more thing. As you can see, I picked up a rocker. So we're about to get a little rocking prop and start. I always love the way the spooky rocking chair looks if it moves by itself. So that is pretty cool. What I would like to do is maybe shoot a, I'm going to try to paint it white and maybe probably put a projector in there of a woman sitting in there. Let it rock and a woman disappears, you know, something crazy like that. But I did manage to get one of those CVS projectors, so there you go. Got a place for it now, so that would be pretty cool. Any of y'all have anything like that out there posted, please let me know. I will check out that link, because I think that's pretty sharp. But if you got any idea on how to do that, let me know. So, all right. Bye.
When you're the best of friends, having so much fun together, you're not even aware you're such a funny pair. You're the best of friends. Life's a happy game. You could clown around forever. Neither one of you sees your natural boundaries. Life's one happy game.